Sleep release a secret message, Mastodon has the best week ever, and Mike Shinoda gets called out by ESP Guitars. It's the Week in Metal. Last week, Sleep released this photo on Twitter, and using my expert investigative journalism skills, I deciphered that the band is definitely high and also recording new material. And this week, it looks like I am totally right. Nice. On the band's website, they released this string of Morse code. Let's play it for you. Nope, that is not a new Meshuggah track. It's actually a message that says,
"Initialize new transmission 2017 CE Sleep nearing completion of new album, engineering accomplice, Noelantis, location, 37.8044 North, 122.2711 West. Release date, undetermined. Record label, undetermined."
Noelantis is the keyboardist for Neurosis, the band that Sleep's current drummer Jason Roeder also plays in. Noah also runs a studio in Oakland, which we are assuming is near the Rite Aid located at the coordinates in the message. Since it's been over a decade since the band released their last album, it's not surprising that they don't have a label ready to release this thing, but I'm holding out hope that somebody picks it up soon. Oh. And also that it doesn't suck, but it won't. It's Sleep. They're great. Mastodon also announced some good news this week about their most recent album, Emperor of Sand. The album became their highest seller ever, with over 43,000 units sold in the first week of its release. Especially impressive is that 41,000 of those units were physical or full album downloads, which is rare in this world of digital streaming services. They even beat out Canadian rapper Drake, who, despite having 136,000 units sold, had very low pure sales numbers since most people didn't pay for the album and streamed it instead. It is possible that the free album with a ticket promotion for Mastodon's tour with Eagles of Death Metal may have influenced those numbers, but that has not been made clear. Regardless, metal is very much not dead yet. Congrats, Mastodon. And finally, Linkin Park's Mike Shinoda threw a jab at ESP Guitars in a recent interview with All Things Heavy. When asked about fans' negative reaction to their latest music, Shinoda said, "If the only thing you want to listen to is ESP Guitars through a rectifier amp, then this is not the album for you." The sweethearts at ESP took this comment to heart and released a statement saying, "We're pretty mellow people at ESP, but we were a little taken aback." Although they also took the opportunity to make some hilarious jabs back at Shinoda and Linkin Park, saying, quote, "Once we realized what was being said, which was that ESP Guitars is the iconic representation of the powerful sounds of heavy music, we got it. And then we checked out one of the songs from the album, and yes. Yes indeed, Mike is correct, that is not the sound of ESP Guitars. So in short, ESP is pleased to announce we won't be on the new Linkin Park album, though of course we wish them the best in their ongoing endeavors." Damn, that's a spicy burn. If you've heard any of the new Linkin Park, it is quite a departure from their emo rap nu metal of the past, and is much more the poppy EDM that you'd hear in like a Cialis commercial. This isn't the first time the band has made a big shift in their sound during their 20-year career, but recently it seems they've been pretty bitter about fans asking for material like their old stuff. Anyways, if you give a shit about Linkin Park still, they promise you'll hear their old stuff on their next tour, so feel free to do that to yourself if you are so inclined. And that's it for this week. What do you think of the new Mastodon album? Are you looking forward to Sleep's next venture? Let me know in the comments, and also check out the hilarious video our own Bloodbath McGrath made where he forced innocent Harry Potter fans to listen to metal. It's great. We'll see you next time.